I was born in a barber shop. My father was a barber, my grandfather was a barber. And I was about 12 years old, and I was already started to cut the kids' hair and worked my way up then. It's the only thing I know.
Candid, how are you?
To me, my customers are like my friends.
Hey, Mom.
No, customer, I've been cutting the hair now for over 60 years. And the reason why I'm still cutting hair, because I just hate to give my customer up. I give a customer what customer wants. I don't give anything the customer don't want. Like a lot of places, you gotta get a shampoo. If you want a hot dog, I don't want nobody to give you a steak. That's been my philosophy. Santa Caterina, St. Catherine. Right in the heart of Sicily. New Year's Eve, I was in the Ellis Island the whole week because then TB was bad, you know. On the day after New Year, they took my x-ray and they let me out. And I came to Chicago then. When I saw the Palmer House, it was pretty exciting. They had people from all over the world, really. I mean, you didn't even know who's gonna walk in. Liberace was the one, the first Jack Benny was really the number one. I never forget him, you know, the way he... Has anybody cut my hair? Liberace, I had to go to his room. He wouldn't come to the barbershop. And he had the mirror in his hand at all the time. He used to come in the barbershop too. Tony Ayupa, Phil Aldorizio, Camelback Humphrey, don't ask any questions, just cut the hair and let them go. We had all the people in the loop that come there for shave. Every morning, so we had from 7 to 9, so we had the shaving and shoe shine. Shaving and shoe shine. People before going there, the office would come there for shave every day. It was the best place you could work for. A lot of customers, so I get the haircut, so they tell me all the problems. Like a lot of people have problems with wives, and tell her, you know, I've been married for 64 years. Sometimes you gotta say yes, sometimes you gotta say no. That's the way marriage works.
Things are really have changed, you know.
3 days home, it's enough for me. I'm gonna work until the day comes, you know.